Okay, hello students, welcome back. So with respect to our last class, I had given you a brief view regarding how to install with XAMPP as an software, then how to run your very first script there. Okay, that's with a simple calculator was there. Okay, so now let us come across in today's class with the second script. Okay, this is just as similar as with your first script there. Okay, just for so that you will be aware, or else it will be an revised to you guys. Okay, so what you have to do is, the very first one is, now already as you have installed with the XAMPP as in software, so what you can do is, it will be appearing here, okay, on your screen. So just click on it with the XAMPP, then here you have to start with this Apache. Okay, so it will start out, then minimize it. Okay, what you have to do is, which I have recommended, is type this particular second program. Now I have already uploaded it in the Google Classroom. Okay, you can just get the downloaded from there with your second experiment. So what you have to do is, you have to write up this particular code, okay, so in a notepad, as I had said you. So for that thing, go to notepad. Okay, so I'll click on this notepad, then here write the code for the second experiment, whatever is there. Okay, so my second experiment doesn't end only here. Okay, so it has been followed across further with a small script again. Okay, so I'll just follow it then. Okay, so as I am doing a copy paste work, which I recommend you guys do not do it. Okay, so afterwards, one very important thing is, what you have to do, you have to save this particular file. Okay, so where are you saving it? Save this particular file. Okay, where you have to save it? Yesterday I had said you htdocs. Okay, save in this particular location only. Okay, this htdocs is available in XAMPP, where your XAMPP is there. So there htdocs as a folder is available, and in that folder itself you have to save the file. And how to name that particular file? Name anything with whatever you are interested with, and your extension should be, for HTML documents it should be .html. And here I'd particularly say that instead, do not select text documents, select it as all files. Okay, then save this particular file. Okay, now as you have saved this particular file, now next what you have to do is, you have to run this script. How to run the script? Click on Google Chrome. Okay, so you will find this particular opening there. Okay, then here use across with local host. Okay, and give a slash. Okay, and here use your experiment number, whatever you had given there. Okay, it would wtlab2.html, whatever I have saved it. Okay, so when I run that particular script, this is the output what you are getting, and the aim of this particular program is, you are getting the square root and cube root of the particular numbers till, from 0 till 10. Okay, so you are getting it as, for 0, 0 is a square, 0 is a cube, 1. Okay, so like this, you have already written a code for this, and this is the output for the same. Okay, so this is with your second script. I hope so everyone has got to know now. Okay, so next I will be explaining across with the third script there. Okay, so third script is with respect to your text growing and increasing font size there. Okay, so for that also, so what you guys have to do is, just write the same. I will be uploading this also, as I have not uploaded it yet. Okay, so you have to write this particular thing in another notepad script there. Okay, so the code doesn't end there, it is at followed across. Okay, I'll just tell you. Okay, so followed out with that. Okay, start entering it. Okay, then here there are two ends what you have to do. One is, you have to end with a body. Okay, and one more, you have to end with HTML. Okay, so this is what we have to do. Okay, so once this has been done, what you have to do is save that particular file. Okay, so as I said to you, again save the file in htdocs as a folder. Okay, so in this htdocs as a folder, use this thing, wtlab3.html. okay, save it in all files. Okay, save this one. Okay, then what you have to do is, go to Google Chrome. Okay, so here in this local host, okay, so use out with, what is the experiment number, w3.html. okay, so you have the text growing from so and so size to and next one. Okay, font size reach 50 point, text will now shrink. Okay, so it is shrinking back. Okay, so this is for your JavaScript on with your second and third experiments. Okay, thank you. Just run these two things and let me know with your doubts if you are facing any. Thank you.